Hello, welcome to the course on Hadoop development offered by Dataraj Academy. My name is Venu, and in today's session, we will discuss about Apache Hadoop releases and versioning. I hope you'll all find this session interesting and informative. In this session, we will attempt to get some clarity on the Apache Hadoop releases and versioning. On the face of it, just by looking at the title of the session, one might think that this is of little value or not so important. But one thing has to be kept in mind is that each of these sessions are meticulously planned to set a logical flow of knowledge on Hadoop. Good knowledge on the releases and versioning will help one in planning and setting up Hadoop cluster conveniently. This knowledge will also be very helpful while choosing a distribution of Hadoop. In this session, we will also touch some essential concepts like semantic versioning, concepts of version control system like branching and merging, software release lifecycle, etc. So let's get started. When planning a Hadoop deployment, one of the first tasks is selecting the version and the distribution of Hadoop that is most appropriate for our work. The right approach for this is to understand the nature of problems we intend to address using Hadoop deployment. This process requires us to take inputs from those who will eventually use the Hadoop cluster. It could be developers, analysts, and possibly other systems such as business intelligence applications. Their inputs will help us in understanding the nature of problems we intend to address using Hadoop. Once we do that, we should then look for the right version of Hadoop that offers those features and stability that we require. This is pretty much similar to what we always did while selecting a relational database based on what is required by downstream applications. For instance, some relational databases support extensions to SQL for advanced analytics, while others support features such as table partitioning in order to scale large tables or to improve query performance. So, based on the problems we need to address, we pick a database that best suits our needs from the vast range of relational databases available in the market today. Hadoop is, as previously mentioned, an Apache Software Foundation project. We can visit the Apache Software Foundation's projects directory page where we can find the list of all the Apache projects. When we search in for Hadoop, we get some information about Hadoop, like its homepage and its mailing lists. The Apache Software Foundation is where all Apache Hadoop development happens. This means it's available directly from Apache in both source format, which is raw and uncompiled code. Source format is a human-readable version of the application, and it has to be compiled before it can be used. And also in binary format, which is compiled code. Binary releases contain computer-readable version of the application, meaning it is compiled. We can download Hadoop directly from the Apache Hadoop official project website, which is hadoop.apache.org. When we click on the download link in the Getting Started section, we will be redirected to the releases page from where we can download Hadoop. Apache Hadoop is distributed as tarballs containing both source and binary artifacts. Tarball is a frequently used jargon term for an archive that has been created with the tar command. An archive is a single file that contains any number of individual files plus information to allow them to be restored to their original form by one or more extraction software tools. Starting around version 1.0, support for building RPM and Debian packages was added to the build system, and later releases provide these artifacts for download. We will elaborate more on this later when we download and set up Hadoop. All code produced by the Apache Software Foundation is Apache licensed. The Apache license is an open source software license released by the Apache Software Foundation. It's a popular and widely deployed license backed by a strong community. We can refer to Apache organization's license page to understand what it means and what it is composed of. The Apache license allows us to freely use, modify, and distribute any Apache licensed product. However, while doing so, we are required to follow the terms and conditions of the Apache license. Alternatively, we can also refer to the Wikipedia page of Apache license to get the bird's eye view of what the license contains. As an open source project, Hadoop has been under active development over the past few years. Historically, Apache Hadoop has produced infrequent releases. Although starting with version 1.0, this has changed with releases coming more frequently. New versions are being released regularly. It is recommended to visit the official Apache Hadoop releases page and have a good look at it. These new releases either fix bugs contributed by the community, leading to a more stable Hadoop software stack, or add new features for the purpose of more full-fledged and enterprise-level distribution. We can also find the release notes on the same page, which briefly describes the details of each release. On keen observation, we can notice the following. Apache Hadoop release versioning format. Apache Hadoop uses a version format of x.y.z, where x, y, z are numeric values. Versions can also have additional suffixes like alpha or beta, which denotes the stage of the software in the software release lifecycle. Apache appears to be following a system called semantic versioning for doing this. Under this scheme, version numbers and the way version numbers change convey meaning about the underlying code and what has been modified from one version to the next. Secondly, we can observe that there are parallel releases happening. Like for example, Hadoop 2.8.3 version got released before Hadoop 2.7.5. Similarly, Hadoop 2.9.0 version was released before Hadoop 3.0.0. This is due to the branching and merging in maintaining the source code repositories. The Hadoop source code resides in the Apache subversion repository. Now it is clear that to understand the Hadoop versioning and releases, we need to know three things broadly: semantic versioning scheme, concepts of branching and merging, software release lifecycle. We will briefly discuss about these now. Semantic versioning specification. It is a simple set of rules and requirements that dictate how version numbers are assigned and incremented. These rules are based on, but not necessarily limited to, pre-existing widespread common practices in use in both closed and open source software. In general, the release version number of a Hadoop distribution consists of three parts: Hadoop, x.y.z. X represents a major release, Y represents a minor release, and Z represents a point release. For example, change in major release can break the backward compatibility. That is, code written in compliance with the API of older releases might not work in the next major release. For example, code written to work on Hadoop x.0.0 might not work on Hadoop x+1.0.0. Whereas, a change in minor release do not break the backward compatibility. That is, code written in compliance with the API of older releases will also work in the next minor release. For example, code written to work on Hadoop x.0.0 will also work on Hadoop x.1.0. Similarly, change in point release do not break the backward compatibility. That is, code written in compliance with the API of older releases will also work in the next point release. For example, code written to work on Hadoop x.0.0 will also work on Hadoop x.1.0 and also on Hadoop x.1.1. Now, let us take an example to understand this better. We have made some changes to our software. Given that software's version number as major.minor.point, we should increment the numeric value of major if we made incompatible API changes. That is, if our changes breaks the backward compatibility partially or completely. We should increment only the minor version number if we added functionality in a backwards compatible manner. And we should increment only the point release version number if we only made backwards compatible bug fixes. Additional labels for pre-release and build metadata are available as extensions to the major.minor.patch format. We will discuss about it shortly. To the curious few who want to know more about the semantic versioning scheme, can visit the official website where you can find answers to most of your questions. Now, let us have a quick look at the Hadoop releases using a diagram. Hadoop 0.20.0 released in April 2009. A point release, Hadoop 0.20.1, with some minor bug fixes, was released in September 2009. Hadoop 0.20.205 release is from the 0.20 security code line and was released in October 2011. Hadoop 1.0.0 major release, which is also from the 0.20 security code line, was released in December 2011. Time has come for us to understand the concepts like branching and merging. We will revisit this diagram once we are done with these concepts, and we will see if we can understand the diagram more better. One of the most useful features of software version control is branching. Branching means taking the current state of the repository and creating a new copy so as to make the necessary changes in it. Let us try to understand this with an oversimplified example. In our example, the repository contains just a single file containing features A, B, and C. A repository is a central place or location to keep resources like files that users can pull from when necessary. Now, we have a main branch or trunk which represents the original state of the repository. We want to make changes in the file, but we don't want those changes to take effect in the original copy of the product or code that is already working. What we can do is, we can resort to branching. Once we branch, we can see the main trunk still contains the file with features A, B, and C, and so does the branch. In the new branch, which at this point of time is just a copy of the repository of trunk, we can make any changes we want and it won't affect the original copy of the product or code that is already working. This is like a perfect sandbox in which we can experiment on the code. We can delete old unnecessary features and add brand new ones. We really have full freedom to do anything we want to. Now, we may delete the feature C and add feature D in the branch, and this does not affect the main branch in any way. In the main branch, that is the trunk, we may add a new feature F. And back in the branch, we might delete feature B now and add feature E. And this is all without changing our main code line. Any member of the community can create a branch for a release and name it whatever they like. Bugs are fixed, and after a vote, a release is declared for that particular branch. In distributed version control systems such as Git, branching is really very easy and cheap because it only creates a 40-byte file, simply creating a new GUID, indicating a new path of changes. By and large, in Apache projects, new features are developed on a trunk, which is the main code line. Occasionally, very large features are developed on their own branches with the expectation that they will later merge into the trunk. Hand in hand with branching is the reverse process called merging. Merging allows us to take changes that we have made in a branch and add them back to the main trunk or into another branch. For example, we have our main branch and this is our main file. We will create a new branch feature 1 as we did before. That is, we are taking a copy of main file 1. We will add a feature D. And now back in the main branch, we will add feature F. And here in parallel, we are going to add feature E in the feature 1 branch. So, as we do these changes, we might decide that we like both sets of changes and want to combine them. In this case, we do not have any conflicting changes because we did not delete anything. We can ask version control system to merge the two branches together, and we will end up with a new file 1 checked into the main branch with all the features from the main branch and the feature branch. Our example is a very simple case, but there could be some complex conflicting situations. In case of conflicting situations, the version control system cannot decide what to do. It declares a merge conflict and requests us to resolve manually. What happens is that the version control system brings a differencing tool to allow us, the humans, to look at the lines that have changed in the context and make a decision of whether we want to take version from the main branch or the version from the feature branch or both changes. Alternatively, we can use a professional full-featured differencing tool to compare the changes in the files. On Windows, it is recommended to use a tool called Beyond Compare to use as a differencing tool. Whereas, on the Mac and Linux, there are many different tools that will allow us to do this effectively. There are many benefits of using a version control software. It allows for easy manageability of multiple versions of the same software. It also acts as a file differencing tool and allows us to compare different files. One of the great benefits of version control software beyond differencing is that not only will it allow us to see the various changes we have made to the code, but it will also allow us to see the commit messages of different developers to determine the intent of the developer who made the changes, so that we could understand how to merge the two branches together effectively. Branching and merging are the two most powerful features of a version control system, and they have to be used with care and thought. They are the most powerful features that we can use because they allow us to experiment and work in parallel and then bring our work back together again at the end to create a complete project or product. Now, we will review the history of releases of Hadoop, pointing out some features of these releases. The initial code that was factored out of Nudge consisted of about 5000 lines of code for HDFS and about 6000 lines of code for MapReduce. Hadoop 0.1.0 was released in April 2006. It continues to evolve through the many contributions that are being made to the project. Hadoop has seen significant interest over the past few years. This has led to a proportional increase in features and bug fixes. Some of these features were so significant or had such a sweeping impact that they were developed on branches. This in turn led to a somewhat confusing array of releases and parallel lines of development. Here is a quick tour of some of the popular lines of development and their status. The 0.20.0 branch of Hadoop is extremely stable and has been used in production for a long time. This branch has been one of the longest lived branches in Hadoop's history since being at Apache. One of the important features missing in this branch was support for file appends in HDFS. Apache HBase, when set up on Hadoop, uses some basic functionality as file append. Append was considered a potentially destabilizing feature and many disagreed on the implementation. So it was relegated to a branch. This branch was called 0.20 append. No official release was ever made from the 0.20 append branch. Yahoo, one of the major contributors to Apache Hadoop, invested in adding full Kerberos support to core Hadoop. It later contributed this work back to Apache in the form of the 0.20 security branch, a version of Hadoop 0.20 with Kerberos authentication support. This branch later went on to be released as the 0.20.20x releases. There was a strong desire within the community to produce an official release of Hadoop that included the 0.20 security work. The 0.20.20x releases contained not only security features from 0.20 security, but also bug fixes and improvements on the 0.20 line of development. Now, they are superseded by 1.0.0. The 0.21.0 branch was cut from the Hadoop trunk and released in August 2010. This was considered a developer preview or alpha quality release to highlight some of the features that were currently in development at the time. Despite the warning from the Hadoop developers, a small number of users deployed the 0.21.0 release anyway. This release does not include security but does have append. Now hold on, because this is where the story gets weird. In December 2011, the Hadoop community released version 0.22.0, which was based on trunk like 0.21.0 was. This release includes security, but only for HDFS. Also a bit strange, 0.22.0 was released after 0.23.0 with less functionality. In November 2011, version 0.23.0 of Hadoop was released. Also cut from trunk, 0.23.0 includes security, append, yarn, and HDFS federation. This release has been dubbed as a developer preview or alpha quality release. This line of development is superseded by 2.0.0. In a continuing theme of confusion, version 1.0.0 of Hadoop was released from the 0.20.205 line of development. This means that 1.0.0 does not contain all the features and fixes found in the 0.21, 0.22 and 0.23 releases. That said, it does include security. In May 2012, version 2.0.0 was released from the 0.23.0 branch. Mainly this is because it includes yarn. While yarn is API compatible with MapReduce version 1, the underlying implementation is different enough for it to require more significant testing before being considered production ready. Now, let us get back to the official Apache Hadoop releases page and let us concentrate on the latest Apache Hadoop 3.0.0 release. On 13th December 2017, after 4 alpha releases and 1 beta release, Apache Hadoop 3.0.0 was made generally available. 3.0.0 generally available release consists of 302 bug fixes, improvements, and other enhancements since its beta 1 release. Altogether, 6,242 issues were fixed as part of the 3.0.0 release series since 2.7.0 release. Apache Hadoop 3.0.0 incorporates a number of significant enhancements over the previous major release line, which is Hadoop 2.x.x. This release is generally available, meaning that it represents a point of API stability and quality that we can consider production ready. The earlier releases of Hadoop 3 are depicted in this table. Hadoop 3 Alpha 1 is the first alpha in a series of planned alphas and betas leading up to a 3.0.0 generally available release. The intention is to release early, release often, to quickly iterate on feedback collected from downstream users. Please note that alpha releases come with no guarantees of quality or API stability and are not intended for production use. Now, what exactly is alpha and beta release and what does generally available mean? Why is Hadoop 3 released so many times with appendages of terms like alpha and beta? To understand this, we need to know about the software release lifecycle. In general, a computer software goes through a software release lifecycle. A software release lifecycle is the sum of the stages of development and maturity for a piece of computer software. It ranges from its initial development to its eventual release, and it includes updated versions of the released version to help improve software or fix software bugs still present in the software. The alpha test terminology is used to denote the pre-announcement test, and beta test is used to show product readiness for general availability. In simple terms, the alpha phase of the release lifecycle is the first phase to begin software testing. Alpha software can be unstable and could cause crashes or data loss. Alpha software may not contain all the features that are planned for the final version. In general, external availability of alpha software is not common in proprietary software, while open source software often has publicly available alpha versions. Beta phase is the software development phase following alpha. Software in the beta stage is also known as betaware. Beta phase generally begins when the software is feature complete, but likely to contain a number of known or unknown bugs. Software in the beta phase will generally have many more bugs in it than completed software, as well as speed performance issues, and may still cause crashes or data loss. The process of delivering a beta version to the users is called beta release. Beta version software is often useful for demonstrations and previews within an organization and to prospective customers. General availability is the marketing stage at which all necessary commercialization activities have been completed and a software product is available for purchase, depending, however, on language, region, electronic versus media availability. Commercial activities could include security and compliance tests, as well as localization and worldwide availability. At this stage, the software is said to have gone live. Hadoop 3 and Hadoop 2 diverged in 2011 itself. There is a lot of content in trunk that did not make it to the 2.x branch. Hadoop 3 is an attempt to implement all those left out features. It has significant number of new features. One important point to be noted is that Hadoop 3 still uses YARN like Hadoop 2. Minimum JDK for Hadoop 3 is JDK 8. The idea is to leverage the new features like Lambda expressions, advanced stream API, security enhancements and performance enhancements for hash maps, IO, NIO, etc. So, which version should we choose for our deployment? The version of Hadoop that we should select for our deployment should be ultimately be driven by the feature set we require for our applications. For many, only the stable releases targeted for production use are an option. Generally, we need to consider two properties, stability and features. For a production deployment, we definitely want to deploy a stable release and we want to use the release that contains all the necessary required features that we need for our application. Finally, we want to hear from you. As the viewer of this tutorial, you are our most important critic and commentator. We value your opinion and want to know what we are doing right, what we could do better, and any other words of wisdom you are willing to pass our way. We welcome your comments. Your feedback will be enormously helpful in improvising the final shape of this course. So please subscribe to the Data Raj channel and contribute any questions, comments, or suggestions in the comment section below. Thank you.